Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi! My name is Carrie. I'm an urban fantasy writer planning to independently publish my series, Witches of Coolersville, which is a new adult urban fantasy series. And this channel is all about bookish stuff and chronicling my writing journey. I wanted to get on here this morning and talk about something important that's been going on in the past week or so. I plan to do a tag video and something fun, but this is a huge matter that needs to be addressed. Now, I am not an expert in the publishing industry. I am still trying to learn and educate myself in all parts of writing and publishing, so when the day comes, I can best work out how to get my books in the hands of readers, and hopefully that will include you sitting here watching this video. So, one of my favorite authors to follow about news with the writing industry is Susan Tisdale. She's a romance author, historical romance. I haven't read any of her books, but her videos are amazing. I discovered her on Facebook. She's so much fun and hilarious, and when there's an issue, she does not hesitate to inform her readers and other authors about it, and she does her best to be educated about it so we get the whole picture. She has posted videos about Cuckygate, if you guys remember that from like a year or two ago, and people that tried to scam the system. And last week she shared a video about a Miss Christiane Serrera, and I don't know if I'm saying this name right, but I believe she's from Brazil. Anyway, she was pumping out books left, right, and center on Amazon, and it was discovered that it was not her book, not her own work. She was taking massive chunks from other authors' books and copying them into her books, slap a cover on them, and put them on Amazon and let the cash roll in. Well, these are some pretty big names. I had shared a list on my author page last week, and the number has since gone up of authors and titles. But the names include, let me know if you've heard any of these, Courtney Milan, Tessa Dare, Bella Andre, Callie Hart, Carolyn Sparks, and the queen of romance herself, Nora Roberts. Plus, she's taken recipes from Jamie Oliver and articles from The Guardian and The Knot, which is the big wedding website. She has since been branded Copypaste Chris on Twitter, and multiple authors that she has stolen from have responded promising legal action against this theft. Because that's what it is, guys. Plagiarism is theft. You're taught this in grade school when you're learning to write papers. Cite your work or it's considered stealing. Don't copy your classmates' paper. It's stealing. Like, common sense. Do your own work. Write your own books. One of the stories she tried to tell to defend herself in this whole thing and claim ignorance, which is total bullshit, was blaming her ghostwriters. Well, some of her ghostwriters have come out and said, I worked with what she gave me, and whether or not she took my edits or not, and oh, by the way, she didn't pay me. She gave me some sob story about how she suddenly had bills to pay and she couldn't pay me. Supposedly she hired these people on Fiverr, which is like one of the cheapest service websites out there. And basically they're like, yeah, she didn't pay me, so I'm not taking the blame of this. So that's a great big you. And that's a whole other topic I could get into, but I don't know much about like being a ghostwriter or ghostwriting, so to comment on it. So I'm just gonna go back to what I was originally planning to talk about. I'm going to link a bunch of responses in the description. My favorite is probably the latest one from Nora Roberts. I think I seriously fell in love with her even more when I read this post. I love her work anyway. I have several of her books, and she does not hold back from this bitch, because she has had 5 titles, plagiarize from one person. Five. From one of the biggest names, not just in romance, but in writing, period. And, oh, she does not hold back. And she makes a promise that she will use every connection she has to take legal action and make sure that this person cannot publish another word. And seeing stories like this person, because she does not deserve to be called an author, because she does not write her own shit, makes me so upset and kind of discouraged as to where my own writing career will be when I'm able to publish. Because Amazon, now being hashtagged as Scamazon on Twitter, I saw that on Susan's Twitter page and kind of love it, is so saturated with people who scam the system to make a buck. And they don't care about the credible indie authors who spend years working on their book. Publishing is a fast cash scheme for them. And now, I have been working on my book series for 5 years. 5 years. I started writing the first book in Witches of Coolersville in 2014 while recovering from a severe blood clot, I might add. I still wrote. I'm currently outlining book three. I'm trying to get as much outlining and pre-planning and writing done before I have my baby in July. But 5 years. 5 years of late nights trying to nail down just the right line of dialogue for a scene. 5 years of researching different things to include in my story, because I write about like witches and supernatural kind of stuff like that, so I want to make sure that I get everything, you know, right. 5 years of either skipping time with friends so I can write, or sometimes I bring my work with me so I can write and hang out with friends. 5 years of educating myself on the writing craft and publishing industry so I can make the best decision for my career. 5 years of pouring my heart and soul into these characters who have become such a huge part of my life. Like, I have dreams about story ideas featuring these people in my head. 5 years of trying to tell stories that I can share with the world, and I've worked so hard and have dreamed of becoming an author since I was a kid. Being an author is not a get-rich-quick career path. And for those who treat it as such are giving independent writers such a bad name. We're already discredited by the literary snobs who think if you're not traditionally published, then you're not a real author. Well, yeah, you throw in those people who copy their work or cause all of this drama, and yeah, those are not credible people. But they are being lumped into a group with credible people, and it's mind-boggling. And that's one of the things that I love about Susan, because she will get responses when she shares this kind of news with people. Like, she will share, she will get responses from people like, oh, I think I'm just gonna give up. And like, there's no point. I can't beat the system, so why even bother? And she says, no. When you give up on your dream of becoming a real, legitimate author, whether you're doing self-publishing or traditional publishing or whatever path you choose, because there's nothing wrong with either, you let the scammers win. And we can't do that. We have to all... the writing community, the real writing community who puts their heart and soul into these books, need to come and band together to tell Amazon, hey, knock this shit out. Don't allow these people to publish. Fix your system so that you can pick up on more of this plagiarism and the people who stuff the books. Susan has a whole other video on that too. That was an issue last year. Of just people, like, cramming books with crap, just to get the page reads on KU, because Kindle Unlimited pays you by the page read. then they would hire all of these they would hire people to just click through the book and rack in the money. So there's nothing wrong with self-publishing if you do it right and you work for it. There's nothing wrong with traditional publishing if you do it right and you work for it. It takes years to make it in this industry. Writing a book is just the start. There's getting it polished. There's promoting it, the actual publication, which is edits, cover design, formatting, any of the legal stuff that comes with having writing as your business. Because when you're an author, you are a business owner. Your name becomes your brand. And especially with all of these thieves and scammers out there, by God, get your book copyrighted. Take every precaution you can to protect your work and your name from horrible people like this. So let me know in the comments what you think of this whole thing. The description, like I said, is going to be full of links about the story. I included Nora Roberts and Courtney Milan's blogs, responses, and one of Susan's videos about this. I almost wonder if Amazon isn't cracking down on stuff like this because they're profiting from it, which in case I'm more confused about what I should do now because I almost want to skip Amazon, like try to avoid it altogether when I publish, but that comes with its own set of problems because it is such a huge market for books. So, if you are more educated in this than I am, like let me know if you have any advice on what I should do, and what other authors can do, or if we should just continue making as much noise as we can until somebody listens and cracks down on this crap. Anyway, thank you for listening. I need to go have some breakfast and calm down because I have a doctor's appointment today and she will probably wonder why my blood pressure is so high. So, have a great day. I will finally have my next blog up on Wednesday, The Misadventures of an Indie Author. I'm actually going to go get some footage later once the sun comes up a little bit more. Because we had an eventful weekend. So, all of my links are also in the description. They are further below all of the important stuff. And thanks for listening, and have a great day, everybody, and have a great week. I'll talk to you later.